Welcome to Communication Engineering playlist. Here in this session, I'll be solving examples on thermal noise. So let us begin this session with first problem. So in this question, an amplifier has a bandwidth of 4 megahertz. So let us mention it. Bandwidth of this amplifier, that is 4 megahertz with 10k as input resistor. So resistor is given by 10 kilo ohm. Calculate the RMS noise voltage at input to this amplifier if room temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. So here temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. So in terms of Kelvin, it will be 25 plus 273. So that will be 298 Kelvin, and Boltzmann's constant, that will be 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 joule per Kelvin. So these are the data which is given to you. Now we are dealt with to calculate RMS noise voltage. So for thermal noise, RMS noise voltage, that we can calculate by square root of 4KTBR. This formula that we have already seen in our theory, so you can see it from there even. In my previous session, I have explained this. So if we place values over here, then we can be able to calculate this data, where K is Boltzmann's constant, 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 into temperature, that is 298, into bandwidth, that is 4 megahertz, into resistor, that is 10 kilo ohm. So if you calculate this, you will be getting RMS noise voltage, and in this case it is 25.64 microvolt. So RMS noise voltage, that we can calculate by square root of 4KTBR, and that is how we can calculate RMS noise voltage at input side. Now let us move on to next question. Here two resistors, one is of 20K and second is of 50K, are at room temperature of 290 Kelvin. So let us mention it. Here R1, that is 20K, R2, that is 50K, and that is connected in some way at room temperature 290. So room temperature, that is 290 Kelvin. And this is what, 20k ohm, 50k ohm. Determine for the bandwidth of 100 kilohertz. So bandwidth is given by 100 kilohertz. The thermal noise for the condition for each resistor. Second is for two resistors in series, and third is for resistors in parallel. We are dealing with to calculate. Now see, each resistor value that is given to us, R1 and R2, that is 20K and 50K. For second case, we have resistor in series. So series resistor, that will be R1 plus R2, that will be 70K. And for parallel resistor, it will be R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. And that will be, if you calculate this, that will be 14.86 kilo. So for, sorry, 14.28 kilo. So this is what parallel resistor combination for this. Now for each resistor, we are dealing with to calculate thermal noise, and as we know the basic formula. So for first case, 4 20k resistor thermal noise that we can calculate by square root of 4k t b r1, 4 resistance r1, and if you calculate value you will be finding it is 4 into 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 into temperature, that is 290 Kelvin into resistance R1. So resistance R1 is 20K, so 20 into 10 to the power 3, and bandwidth, that is 100 kilohertz, so that is 100 into 10 to the power 3. And if you calculate this, you'll be finding this value, that will be 5.66 microvoltage. Now see, similarly you can calculate for 50k ohm, where you just need to place this formula 4k t b r2. You just write down your answer in comment. I'm not calculating it, it is having similar calculation. So you just give me your answer in comments. 4 series, that resistance, that is 70k. So even this is what you can calculate by this basic formula, 4k t b r s, and even you just give me your answer in comments. So similar calculation is there. And 4 parallel, that is 14.28 kilo ohm, and similar formula that we'll have to use and calculate that RMS voltage. I'm just waiting for your reply in comments. You just give me your answer. So this is how we should calculate it. I have shown you calculation. Now all you need to do is you just use this formula and calculate your answer. Just give me your answer in comments so that I can see how you are calculating this and whether answer is correct or not. Now see, in next question, calculate the thermal noise power available for any resistor at room temperature 290 Kelvin. So temperature is given by 290 Kelvin for a bandwidth 2 megahertz. So bandwidth, that is 2 megahertz, 2 into 10 to the power 6 hertz. And also calculate corresponding noise voltage at R is equals to 100. So R is equals to 100 ohm. And Boltzmann constant, that is 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 joule per Kelvin. Now see, first question, that is to calculate thermal noise power. So thermal noise power that we can calculate by KTB, where K is Boltzmann's constant, 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23, temperature, that is 290 Kelvin, and bandwidth, that is 2 megahertz, so 2 into 10 to the power 6. So if you calculate this, you will be getting 8 into 10 to the power minus 15 volt. So this will be thermal noise power. You just calculate this, you will be getting this 8 into 10 to the power minus 15 volt. And second is calculate corresponding noise voltage. So as we know, P is equals to V square by R. We can calculate V, that is square root of P into R. And if you place values, where P is 8 into 10 to the power minus 15 and R is 100. So this voltage, that will be 0.894 microvoltage. So you'll be getting this answer, 0.894 microvoltage. So see, basic formula for thermal noise voltage, RMS voltage. So this is what, remember this mistake that students do is, this is what VRMS, That is what square root of 4KTBR. This is RMS value. And when you calculate thermal noise power, so that is P is equals to KTB. See, this is what we need to keep in our mind. If you calculate these examples in this way, then it will be fine. Otherwise, it is possible you may do error. Like, see, over here, you'll be finding we are using power formula, that is KTB. So that is what instantaneous maximum power. It is not RMS power. So based on that formula of voltage, that is what square root of PR. But when you calculate RMS at that time, you should use this formula. So this is how difference is there in terms of formula, and you should use it accordingly. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give me your valuable suggestions and write down answers which I have asked in this question over here in comments. Thank you so much for watching this video.